Hey guys, my name is Jessie Mew, and welcome back to Niche, a genetic survival game. A big thank you to Pastel over on Twitter for this gorgeous artwork of Animeme, which is a pretty fitting image to look upon as we return to work on Animeme's pack. Animeme has actually been a very kind goddess to us so far, as she's given us all of these very strong little critters with their big double claws and their poison fangs. We're actually working on the poison fang line right now, and hopefully Lalana will be able to breed with, I believe it was Kukirkir pretty soon, because not only are we hoping that this double claw situation is going to be passed along to their future children, but I also noticed that both of them have the panda markings carried in their genes, so hopefully that means that the pandas are not going to die off with a meme, because at the moment she is getting very, very old. She's actually pregnant with her very last child that we're hoping she's going to be able to give birth to. In the next turn, once she has some more energy, we're actually going to move Sierra off of this nest and see if she can possibly make it for just one more baby. But hopefully the panda markings won't die with her, because I did notice that some of our creatures are carrying those. And then we have this little budding family over here, Kuvan and Kolara. They are also expecting their very first child, so on the next turn we'll be able to see what they give us, hopefully a baby with these giant ears. That's what I'm hoping for, and I have a feeling that's going to be the case. I can't imagine that any baby they have together are going to have normal ears. And last but not least, we have this family way off in the swamplands, kind of still searching for some sort of nest to settle down in. Hopefully we'll be able to find that soon. I do want to start moving Isram back so that she can breed with Nukirduk, because they both have those berry paws, and I would like to focus on the berry paws in the swamp, since there are so many berry bushes for us to pick from. It seems like it would be a good idea just to make sure that all of our creatures living in the swamp are able to pick up as many berries as they possibly can. For now though, it looks like we're out of turns for the most part. There's not much food to gather up, and we're kind of low on food anyway, so I am going to skip ahead in the turn right now. And there goes poor little Cece. Unfortunately, she was the next one to pass away. Now let's see if we can scoop up any berries before we start moving these creatures around. Actually, oh my goodness, let's take a look at the baby first. She has green eyes. Anna Isri, I believe her name is. She has green eyes. We haven't seen green eyes in so very long, so I'm really happy to see that. And of course, she has those giant ears, which I am also quite happy to see. She has the panda patterns carried in her genetic slots as well, so hopefully she'll be able to pass that along in the future if we pair her up with the right male anyway. But let's see, can her mother pick these berries? Yes, she can. So she can pick those, and we'll keep an eye on the bunnies too, because I know they were hopping around in this area. You could possibly move up here and pick these berries. There we go. That's a little bit easier. And hey, little bunny, that's mine. That's mine. You're not going to take that on me. It looks like there's actually another one down here, but now we have enough food to move Sierra out of the nest. We'll actually place her right by this bunny burrow for now, because she is also one of the daughters of Rear, so she should be technically on bunny duty pretty soon. So let's move Meme over here. Oh gosh, that is really close. That is really, really close to the end of her life. I'm not sure if she's going to be able to have this baby or not. We're going to cross our fingers though. I hope that she'll be able to. It looks like you, Anar, can pick these berries. And let's see, let's have Isram start coming back too. So Kois, you can actually pick these and peek around in the grass just a little bit more for us, so we can hopefully find a nest up there. And then Isram, you're going to start making your way back. Oh, but first, you do need to grab that bunny, because we are so low on food. So unfortunately, she's going to have to wait until the next turn to start coming back a little bit more. I suppose we could have Kuvan kind of explore, though I would like them to have at least one more baby, so maybe I'll leave him right there for now, and we'll have Vendukvan sort of go off into the wilderness and check out the berry bushes over here. He has a very low speed too, so we have to keep that in mind. It looks like somebody already swiped up those berries, unfortunately. Ah, there he is. There's the little bunny in the grass over there. So I think that's about it for this turn. I know a lot of you guys have actually been asking me about the cactus plants lately, and the reason why I don't use them, even though there's a ton of berries on them, is because they harm the creatures who gather from them. Currently, there's no way in the game to safely gather from the cactus, so if there was an emergency, I suppose we could use them, but I also can't cut them down. Some of you guys have been asking me if I can cut them down, and even Lalana with her double claws can't actually cut these cactus plants down, so that's not possible yet. I have a feeling that the developers probably have something else in mind for these plants. I'm sure eventually they will be implemented in a way that we can use without like completely killing off our creatures in the process. So eventually we'll be able to use these, I'm sure, but for now we're just going to leave them there. And it looks like we could possibly have Kukirkir breed with Lalana soon too. Should we do that on this turn? I suppose we could at least get started on that. We'll have her breed with him, and then that completely runs us out of food, so we'll have to skip the turn now. And let's see. Oh, Meme, you actually had your baby! Yes, she was actually able to have her baby, and it's a blue-eyed baby again. How adorable are you? It looks like you have the berry paw, too, so maybe you could help out our friends in the swamp. And yeah, Meme, you are definitely passing away on the next turn. I don't think there's any hope for you now, which is a little bit sad, because of course we love Meme with her panda patterns and her beautiful name, too. But let's go ahead and pick up some of these berries. We have to steal this from the bunny because he is definitely looking for another snack. And then we'll grab up these berries as well. And then I think I will move you, Lalana, straight over to the nest. We also need to figure out... Oh, I see you over there. Wait a second. Let me grab this guy. There we go. We also need to figure out who Keir Duke is going to breed with because he is currently the only member of our pack with the immunity gene D. So it's very important that we pick some good mates for this guy, because he could possibly save us from our current immunity gene debacle, where every single member of this pack seems to have immunity gene B somewhere in their line, which is why a lot of these creatures are probably going to be born a little bit sick in the near future. But because we have such a large pack, we're not finding any wanderers, and that's going to make it very hard to make sure that these guys are healthy in their immunity genes. But it looks like we could probably push this out a little bit further. There's no berries there because I think that bunny grabbed it, unfortunately. So let's keep looking this way. Nothing there yet. Nothing there yet. I'm a little bit worried that we're not going to be able to find a nest up here. For some reason, it seems like they're just not spawning. I know it seems like there's more nests in the savannah, so... I mean, I would hate to just cluster everyone over here, though. That doesn't seem like it's going to help us very much. And we need to spread these guys out so they can pick all of these berries for us, too. So, Izram, why don't you start coming back as well? That's what we wanted to have you do. It looks like our pathway is kind of blocked by this guy, ironically, so we need to make a different pathway for her to use. But for now, let's just go grab this berry over here, and then we'll skip the turn again, because we are definitely running low on food. Oh, Meme, I hate to see that. And there is actually our first sick child of the day, it looks like. Was that you? Or no, it was your mother. Oh, Lalana, why are you sick? That's not good. She doesn't even have a weak immunity, so that's really disturbing. But it looks like her name is Mienemy? Mienemy? Is that how you would pronounce that? And she is carrying the poison fangs at least, so we could possibly breed that back into the line in the future. She's carrying the panda patterns as well, so they weren't able to have a panda baby just yet, but she is still carrying them, so they did not die with Meme. Don't worry, guys. I am definitely still working on getting us a little panda family in honor of Animeme, in fact. So let's go ahead and gather up the berries again. We always need the berries. And Vanku, you need to get this bunny away from this bush. There we go. Hopefully you can keep an eye on that. Lame. Oh my gosh. Yes, Rear's daughter's name is Lame, and I feel so bad calling her that. I need to find like a different way to pronounce that so I don't have to call her Lame because that sounds so mean. I think I'm going to place her right over here, and then hopefully the bunnies will hop into this grass, but I'm not sure if that's going to work. At least there's a couple berries for us to pick for now. Did you steal my berry? You might have stolen my berry. Oh, geez. At least I can grab these. And it looks like the bunnies are kind of hopping all over the place over here again, which is a little bit worrying. If we could possibly just move her... Oh! Well, you are not a bunny, sir. Okay. But you will help us get food. So that's good. How are you in attack strength? I don't think... Well, she has 4. Okay, because of that big body. That's right. So she could definitely help us out at least. But we don't really have many turns to use, which is the main concern right now. You could gather up some more food for us. That might help us. And it doesn't look like there's any bunnies hopping close enough for me to snag. If I could get Lalana up there in time, then she would absolutely obliterate this guy. But I'm not sure if we're going to be able to. So let's just have Izram attack him for now. You can be our warrior for the day. And then, let's see, how much more does he have? Not too much. That's pretty good. Okay. So we just need to get one more guy up there, basically, to finish him off, it looks like. And New Keir Duke only has one more turn, so he's not going to be able to help us. You are very weak, sir, aren't you? Yeah, with your 3 attack strength, so I'm not sure if that's going to be much of a help either. I suppose we could try, but he won't be able to move back, because it's going to take one move to get him close enough to the carnivore, and then one move to swipe him. So, yeah, just a couple more hits on this guy, and then it should be okay, and I don't think... Oh, gosh, he might be able to kill this guy. Aw, jeez, I should have looked at that before I moved him. Hopefully he's not going to attack him. Hopefully not. But we are out of food at the moment, so I think I'm going to have to skip the turn again. These bunnies are just out of reach too, which is so frustrating. I might actually want to move Liam a little bit closer to the shoreline pretty soon. There are a lot of bunnies down there, so I think it would do us some good. But yeah, we definitely have to skip the turn now. We're only down to one piece of food. Who are you going to attack? Nobody. Okay, well that's fine with me. I don't mind if you don't want to attack us, I guess. We'll just gather up some more food here. There's one of the bunnies. There we go. That'll help us. And you are very, very close to you. And oh my gosh, oh no, I totally missed that. We had another bunny duty member actually die. But let's grab some more of these bunnies while they're in the area. We'll snag these guys up. And then Sierra, it's going to be your job to sit here for now, I suppose. Oh my gosh, and there's another one. Those berry bushes are actually pretty good traps for these guys. We'll leave that meat there for now, I think, unless we have an Anako come collect it so I don't forget about it. That might be a good idea. There we go. We'll have her collect that. And then are there any bunnies over here that I can swipe? It doesn't look like it. They're just a little bit too far away. So we'll have Izram go ahead and attack this guy. And there we go. Now he's done. And you, sir, need to go guard your berry bush, it looks like. There we go. We actually managed to get that bunny too. So now we can gather up all of that meat from the carnivore, which will give us a pretty good boost in our turns. And oh my goodness, there is another bunny. There is another one. They are everywhere, guys. There are so many bunnies in my land right now. It's really hard to keep track of them all. But let's grab this before this bunny does. And Izram, once again, we are going to attempt to move you closer to Nukiriduk. Hopefully in the next turn we'll be able to breed these two and see what sort of baby they give us. Now, Taduk here is also fully grown, so we should be able to breed him with Sierra pretty soon. We'll have to swap Sierra out for Liam. Oh, poor little Liam. So that she can sit on top of the bunny burrow for now. We'll probably do that in the next turn too, and then we can maybe have another baby with Lilana. We'll see if they can give us a little panda baby like we were hoping for. And then we'll have one more baby with Kolara and Kuvan, so we can have our little big-eared branch over on the right side of the island. So I think that's about all that we can do. There's a couple more berries that we could collect, but other than that, oh no, you're gonna steal that on me, aren't you? Vendukvan is all on his own, and he's almost dead too. Oh my gosh, he's going to die of old age. We have to get Kuvan over here so that we don't lose the meat. We'll bring him right over here so that we can at least collect the meat in the next turn, because this area is going to go dark, and that means that I think we're going to lose that meat if the whole area goes dark in the process. So we'll go ahead and collect that in the next turn. Are there any more berries that we can possibly snag up? Neuroduke, you are not exactly old enough to grab that berry right there, so that's not going to help us. Kirduke is also fully grown, so hopefully he'll be able to give us a baby pretty soon too. And I think that's about it. We'll go ahead and skip the turn now. And it's raining! Okay, that's good. That's good news. We have a little bunny to collect. We have all of these berries to scoop up. Let's see. Let's get the bunny first. That's the first priority, because that one will scoot off. And then this guy is already chowing down on all of the berries. But that's okay, because we have so many over here anyway. I don't really mind that he's getting his little fill of food. So we'll have Nukiriduk gather up these as fast as he possibly can. I see you over there. And then we'll have Izram come over here and breed with Nukiriduk. And then hopefully she'll be able to sit on one of these nests over here. I think we should probably have room for her to sit on one of the nests. We'll actually have Neuroduke move out of this nest so that Sierra can move into this one. And then we'll bring Taduk here over here to breed with her. So they'll have a baby in the next turn too. And I think I might actually want to pop the normal eyes in here just in case. Let's see, we'll put it in place of the dots for now. Just in case, because she does carry the blindness gene in her genetics, so I don't want like any surprises at this point. I don't want to accidentally spread the blindness gene all throughout our lines like it was before. If we could just like contain it, then it's fine. We could have that one bunny duty member who sits on the bunny burrows and snags up all of the little bunnies that hop out, but otherwise I am a little bit concerned about it spreading too far. So Kuvan, pick up your meat. And Kolara, you need to gather these berries. Unfortunately, I think she can only gather one at a time, so maybe her baby can come over here and like, yeah, chase that guy away for us. There we go. That should help us out a little bit. So you can gather up a few more of these. And hey, little bunny, I see you again. Let's gather up as much as we can. I think he got one, unfortunately, but there was nothing I could really do about that. That's why we need to make sure that the guys up in the swamps, hello, excuse me, have a lot of berry paws so that they can scoop up as many as possible. And it looks like that might be it for this turn. So let's see. Let's move Mianami out of the nest. And then we'll have Lalana and Kukirkir breed one more time. Because it looks like, unfortunately, since Lalana got sick, she is actually going to be passing away soon as well. So we'll have him come over here really, really quick and breed with her. And all of these bunnies again. And I don't want to forget about Koisui up here either. I don't want to forget about her because she's so far away from the rest of the pack, kind of still trying to push out the territory and explore and find that nest, that she is a bit isolated from everyone else. These bunnies, guys, so many bunnies, so much meat for me to pick up in the next turn. Honestly, I mean, it's good for us. I can't really complain because we do need the food anyway. Let's see, we'll gather up these though. That would probably be a good idea. And we still need to find somebody to gather up these in the next turn too. So Lame, you need to sit right up on top of this bunny burrow for us while your sister gives birth. And we still need to find someone for Kurduke to breed with. So let me know if you guys have a specific idea in mind. It looks like he has the toxic body in his genetics. He's currently carrying that. He has the berry paw. He has the blue eyes in his genetics as well. So maybe we could possibly get that if we pair him up with the right female. So let me know what you guys think. And hopefully we'll be able to do that in the next episode as well. For now, let's move him over here so that he can guard this bush in particular with that berry paw of his. And I think that's it, right? Have we moved everyone where they need to be? I think so. Like, again, the only problem with having so many critters in the pack is that it gets very hard for me to keep track of everyone all at once. So Izram, you still need to come just a little bit closer to the nest. There we go. So hopefully in the next turn, she'll be able to scoot to one of those. And let's see all of these little babies that are going to be born right now. Oh my gosh, we actually managed to get the poison fangs again. Excellent. Rovan, that is an adorable name. And he is carrying blind eyes, but that's okay. That should be okay. And he's also carrying the panda pattern too, which is adorable. Oh my gosh. And then we have this little darling back here, Kolako. And she's carrying the poison fangs and the panda patterns again. So we're not having much luck with the panda patterns, but at least we're still carrying them in the genetics. So hopefully at some point we'll be able to get another panda patterned individual again. Let's go ahead and finish scooping up all of our berries though before the bunnies do. Oh no, and it looks like somebody died back here. Oh no, that may have actually lost us some of the meat that we had laying around there from the bunnies. I'm not sure, we'll have to go check that. Let's see, is there anyone who could scoot on up there and give that a look? I suppose Kukirkir could for now, since he's kind of the closest with energy still on him. And okay, so the meat is still there. That's good to see. We have a ton of meat to collect here. So Kukirkir is going to be the one to scoop up all of that meat. And you are going to be the one to kill that bunny. Thank you. And it looks like we have a couple more berries to collect here as well. So that's good. And let's move Izram finally over to this nest too, so that she can give birth right before we end out the episode. We just have a little bit more food to collect. Once again, we are very, very high in our stock of food, so that's good to see. I love it when it rains because we always have that big burst of food that we can use to continue pushing out the pack's territory. And that'll certainly help us with Koise way out here as she's trying to figure out where those nests are, those pesky little nests. Let's have her move a little bit further. Oh, there's one of the bunny burrows. Excellent. Okay, so we could have another line of bunny hunters way up here at some point. That's quite interesting. Hopefully Rear's daughters will be able to push their line up toward the bunny burrows. That would probably be a neat idea. And then Kuvan, why don't you go ahead and pick this bush for us and kind of peek around in the grass too, so that we can see all of the bunnies when they're hopping out of the grass to steal our berries. So there we go. Is that about it? It looks like there's something rustling over here, so I just want to check it out. There we go, a little bunny. So we managed to get another little bunny. That's good. And I think that's it. We have Izram sitting in the nest, so she should be able to give us a baby in the next turn. And Lalana is probably going to be passing away very soon. I don't think she's going to be able to give us any more babies. So Izram, let's see. What are you going to give us, little Izram? Hopefully a nice berry pawed baby. It looks like, oh my gosh, double berry paws. That's our first time getting double berry paws too. Unfortunately, double immunity gene B as well. But that might make it easier to make sure that her children children are healthy later on when she's grown, because as long as we make sure that the male she breeds with does not have immunity gene B, then that shouldn't be a problem. But she has the big body, which is good to see. She's carrying the poison fangs. She has a 4 in attack strength, but the main concern, the main thing that she's good at is definitely collecting. She can collect 4 berries at a time. So her job will definitely be to sit way up here and collect all of those berries for us in the swamp. But that's great, guys. We're doing pretty good. We're starting to spread our guys around, and we definitely have a lot of food to tie us over as we continue pushing out the territory toward the grasslands here. So I hope you all enjoyed this episode. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys!